I first heard Layla by Derek and the Dominos in August 1972 when it was released as a single in the UK, and it just completely blew me away. It's over 40 years later and I still think that it's a fantastic track. This video is for anyone who wants to know more about how to play the guitar, bass and organ parts for part one of the song and how to achieve the sounds used on the record. Here is the band from left to right: drummer Jim Gordon, bass player Carl Radle, keyboard player and vocalist Bobby Whitlock, and guitarist and vocalist Eric Clapton. Writer's credits for Layla went to Eric Clapton and Jim Gordon. For the recording of the album and a couple of gigs soon after, the band was joined by Duane Allman of the Allman Brothers Band as second guitarist. The Layla and Other Assorted Lovesongs album was recorded between August and October in 1970 at Criteria Studios in Miami. Recording of the Layla track started on Wednesday, September 9th, and the last overdubs were done on Thursday, October 1st, around 3 weeks later. The first part of Layla uses a straightforward structure, with the famous guitar riff used as the introduction, the chorus, and the backing for the guitar solo at the end. There are three verses. The chorus is in D minor, and the verses are a semitone down in C sharp minor. Layla was originally recorded at a tempo of 111 beats per minute and speeded up to 115 beats per minute in post-production. That's about a 3.5% increase. In those days, there was no time stretching software, so increasing the tempo raised the pitch. If you try and play along to the record, you'll find that this is around a semitone sharp as a result of the tempo increase. In this video, we're aiming for concert pitch where A is 440 Hz at 111 BPM. You can pause the video here to study the chords. These are the basic chords, but Eric used a variety of embellishments, which are shown in the video. When the album was originally released, it included track sheets showing who played what on each track. Here is the track sheet for Layla. Eric Clapton has said that Layla is a tricky song to play live due to the number of guitar parts, and it's easy to see why. Of the 16 tracks used for the recording, 6 are used for guitars, and in some instances, there is more than one guitar part on a single track. It isn't completely straightforward to work out who played what, but we can make an educated guess by looking at the panning indications shown at the bottom of each box on the track sheet. L is for left, M is for middle, R is for right, etc. For the album, Eric Clapton used mainly his 1956 Fender Stratocaster that he called Brownie. Eric used a variety of pickup positions depending on the context, including the in-between positions. At the time, you had to jam the three-way switch with something like a business card, as Fender didn't start installing five-way switches until 1977. Duane used firstly a 1957 Gibson Les Paul Goldtop. Duane owned more than one Goldtop, and after the main sessions had finished, one of them was swapped for the 1959 Cherry Sunburst Les Paul Duane is seen playing here. The overdubs were either done on the remaining Goldtop or this Cherry Sunburst Les Paul. Carl Radle is usually pictured playing a Sunburst Fender Precision Bass with a bound jazz bass neck. There are different recollections of what amps are used by Eric and Duane, sometimes by the same people. The consensus is that they were small amps, probably Fender Champs, and that the most likely versions were late 50s Tweed Champs like this one pictured. Tweed Champs can easily get an overdriven tone that can sound massive on record when mic'd up. To lay the speculation to rest, here is a tone test of a Tweed Champ, a Blackface Champ and a Silverface Champ. This is just a Fender Strat plugged straight into the amps without any pedals of any kind. Tweed Champ obviously gives a lot more growl without the need for a distortion pedal, and is very much the closest to the original Layla album in terms of tone. This is the amp that has been used for the majority of this video. For Eric's parts, we'll be using a Fender Stratocaster with late 50s style pickups. For Duane's parts, we'll be using a Gibson Historic 1957 Goldtop. Duane liked to wrap his strings over the stop tail piece of his Les Paul. It gives a slightly different feel and is worth a try. Duane used a variety of pickup combinations and picking positions depending on the song. We'll be using both pickups together with the bridge volume control and the two tone controls dimed, but the neck pickup volume control backed off. For the Hammond organ part, we'll be using a Fender Stratocaster fitted with a Fishman TriplePlay MIDI converter. For the bass part, we're using a Yamaha bass through a THR-10C amp. Eric plays the opening riff in both octaves, tracks 5 rhythm and 12 guitar harmony. Both riffs are played at 3/4 speed and full speed. They are then played in unison. Parts that drive the track along are on track 3, and they are Eric and Duane playing in unison. Here's Eric's part at 3/4 speed and full speed. Eric plays the two harmony parts, tracks 11 and 9, panned hard left and hard right respectively. Here is the low harmony part at 3/4 speed and full speed. Here is the high harmony part at 3/4 speed and full speed. Both parts played together. Eric plays rhythm guitar in the verses on track 5. Each verse is different, so we'll go through each one in turn, both at 3/4 speed and full speed. Thank you. Duane's guitar parts are a combination of slide guitar and fingering. Duane made quite a name for himself as a slide guitar player. Duane played slide guitar using a small bottle made for cold medicine on the ring finger of his left hand. And what is good enough for Duane is good enough for us. When using a bottle for slide, you'll need something to absorb the sweat from your finger. I use chamois leather. When playing slide guitar, Duane used his fingers for picking so he could mute strings at the same time for greater clarity. Duane played slide using a variety of chord tunings as well as standard tuning. It's perfectly possible to play Duane's slide parts on Layla in standard tuning, and that's what we'll be doing here. Everyone has their own way of doing things, but for slide, I like to raise the guitar's action by raising the bridge a little and placing a cocktail stick under the strings behind the first fret. You'll need to tune the guitar before inserting the cocktail stick. Lastly, when playing slide, it's very tempting to really dig in when you're reaching a particularly energetic passage, as you would when you finger notes. Unfortunately, you'll probably ground the strings on the fretboard, so the trick is to continue to play lightly and let the notes speak for you. Duane played the main riff in unison with Eric Clapton on track 3. Firstly, there's Duane's part at 3/4 speed and full speed, followed by Duane and Eric's parts played in unison. Duane played the single line guitar over the verses on track 4. Each verse is different, and so we will go through each one in turn, both at 3/4 speed and full speed. Duane plays the slide solo on track 4, a total of 3 parts. Here is a solo at 3/4 speed and at full speed. ¶¶ Carl Radle's bass line is straightforward, which is just as well given all the interwoven guitar lines. It doesn't vary significantly from chorus to chorus or verse to verse. Here is the chorus and verse bass line played at 3/4 speed and full speed. Bobby Whitlock's Hammond B3 organ underpins the track all the way through, but it can only really be heard on the verses. It doesn't really vary much from verse to verse. Here we're using a Fender Strat and a Fishman TriplePlay to recreate the B3 organ sound. The TriplePlay translates guitar playing into MIDI, which is then used to drive Native Instruments' emulation of a Hammond B3 organ. The part is played at 3/4 speed with just the sound of the guitar unamplified. At full speed, you can hear the sound of the Hammond B3 emulation generated by the guitar's MIDI output. The triple play is a real boon for guitarists who can't play keyboards. And when you put it all together, this is what our version of the entire track sounds like.